Welcome to Electromagnetics playlist. I, Professor Ritesh Dholakia, is going to explain you Cartesian vector to cylindrical vector conversion. And in previous session, I have already explained what is Cartesian vector and how to convert Cartesian point into cylindrical point. So you should understand this. I have not explained Cartesian vector to cylindrical vector. I have explained you Cartesian point into cylindrical point conversion. So here in this session, we will see Cartesian vector into cylindrical vector conversion. So let me write this question first. So here we have been given with vector P, that is AXIX plus AYYY plus AZIZ, and we are dealing with to convert this into ARIR plus AFIIFI plus AZIZ. So how to convert this? So first of all, we should know how those points are there, right? So this point, if I say in terms of Cartesian, if I write that is XYZ, right, and in terms of cylindrical, it will be R, Phi and Z. So to XYZ coordinate, that we know, right? But how R, Phi, Z coordinates are there? So for that, I will be drawing quarter cylinder over here. Now in this quarter cylinder, you can see this is radius, right? This is radius R. This is angle phi, and this length of cylinder, that is Z. So how to represent direction of R phi and Z? So once you know the direction of R phi Z, I think it will be easier to understand conversion. So direction of R, that is there in the radius direction. Direction of R, that is there in the radius direction. You can see this is the radius direction at this point, right? So we can say direction of R, that is there in the radius direction. Let me mention it, IR. Now direction of phi, that is I phi, that is there from X to Y direction and tangent to cylinder. So we can say direction of I phi, that is tangent to cylinder and from X to Y. So see, that will be in this direction, I phi. So that is, so direction of phi, that is tangent to cylinder and from X to Y direction. And if you observe direction of Z, so that is same as it is there with Cartesian. So this is what, IZ. And if you observe all these three directions, so that is perpendicular to each other as it is there with XYZ. So direction of XYZ, that is perpendicular to each other, as well as direction of IR, IFI and IZ, that is even perpendicular to each other. Now let us try to calculate AR, AFI and AZ component from AX, AY and AZ components. So for a calculation of AR component, all we need to do is, you just need to follow this process. AR, that is vector P dot vector IR. Now what is vector P? Vector P is AXIX plus AYIY plus AZIZ dot IR. Now here, if you do this dot multiplication, then you'll be finding this is AX into IX dot IR plus AY into IY dot IR plus AZ into IZ dot IR. Now we need to identify what is this dot for IX dot IR. Now you see, if you observe the direction of IX, so that is there in this direction, IR, that is there in this direction, and angle in between IX and IR, that is phi. So let me mention over here, angle in between IX and IR, that is phi. Now angle in between IY and IR. So if you observe angle in between IR, that is this, and Iy, so that is 90 minus phi. So angle in between Ir and Iy, that is 90 minus phi. And if you observe angle in between Iz and Ir, so Iz is there in this direction and Ir is there in this direction, so this angle is 90 degree, right? So now for a calculation of this, see Ir dot Ix dot Ir, that is cos phi, Iy dot Ir, so that is cos 90 minus phi, so we can say that is sin phi, and cos 90, that is 0. So we can write this Ar, that is Ax cos phi plus Ay sin phi, and this cos 90 is 0. So this is what Ar. Now similarly, we will calculate A phi. Now A phi, that is vector P dot I phi. So vector P, that we know, Ax Ix plus Ay Iy plus Az Iz dot I phi. So that is right. Now we need to identify angle in between Ix and I phi. Right. Now for that we need to have top view over here. So let me draw top view first of all. So it will be giving you idea like how to calculate this. So based on, see, this top view is like, this is x direction and this is y direction, right? And you can see this is a trajectory like this, and in this trajectory, see, this is what the direction which is there in IR direction, right? And tangent to this means this direction, that is there in I phi direction, right? And if you talk about angles, then this angle is phi. So if I take trajectory of phi in this direction, then what is this angle? So see, for this angle, if I say this is 90 degree, right? So this angle has to be 90 minus phi. So let me mention it over here. This angle, that is 90 minus phi. Now this total angle is 180. This total angle is 180. So how much this? So this angle, that has to be 180 minus 90 minus phi. And if you calculate this, then this will be 180 minus 90. So that is 90 minus minus plus phi. So angle in between phi and Aix, that is 90 plus phi. Right. So angle in between Ix and I phi, that is 90 plus phi. So let me mention it over here. This is 90 plus phi. Now this is what Iy and this is what I phi. So angle in between Iy, and you can see this angle is phi. So this angle is exterior angle and that is even phi. So angle in between I phi and Iy, that is even phi. So you can say this angle is phi. And angle in between Iz and phi, Iz, that is perpendicular, you can see, and I phi, that is like this. So angle in between Iz and I phi, that is 90 degree. So I'm writing it, this angle is 90 degree. So now we can say this will be Ax cos 90 plus phi. So that is minus sine phi. So we can say this is minus Ax sin phi. Iy dot I phi, that is cos phi. So we can say plus Ay cos phi. And this is cos 90 is 0. So we don't need to write it. And when you calculate Az, so that is P dot Iz. And that is Ax Iz, Ax Ix plus Ay Iy plus Az Iz dot Iz. Now here you can see ax, ix dot iz, that is 0, and iy dot iz, that is even 0. So iz dot iz, that is 1. So we can say az is equals to az only, right? So basically now we have this ar, aphi and az as per vector calculation. And see, this is what we need to remember even for a solution of exam. Now let us solve one example, so that will give you clear idea. So for example, I'm just giving you one vector and then we will solve that into Cartesian vector. So we have been given with vector f. So here one can see we are dealing with to convert this vector into cylindrical vector. So first we need to calculate, see, for this conversion we need angle phi, right? So as we know, phi is what? Tan inverse ay by ax. So tan inverse ay is 2 divided by ax, that is 2 root 3. So 1 by root 3, that is tan inverse 1 by root 3, that is 30 degree. So now we have angle phi, and now we can calculate ar component. So ar component is ax cos phi plus ay sin phi. Now ax is 2 root 3 cos 30 plus ay is 2 sin 30. So if you calculate this, then you will be getting 1 by root 3, sorry, root 3 by 2. So root 3 into root 3, 3 plus sine 30 is half, so 1. So root 3 plus 1, it will be 4. Then we can calculate Aφ. So that is minus Ax sine phi plus Ay cos phi. So minus 2 root 3 sine 30 plus Ay, that is 2 cos 30. Now you see sin 30 is half, so half will get cancelled, minus root 3, and cos 30 is root 3 by 2, so 2 will get cancelled, root 3. So minus root 3 plus root 3, that will be 0. And az will not change, it will be 4 only, right? So we can say here our vector f in cylindrical coordinate will be ar, that is 4 into ir direction plus 0 into aphi direction plus 4 into iz direction. See, this is how we can translate Cartesian vector into cylindrical vector. I hope that you have understood this. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please do give your valuable suggestions. Definitely, based on your suggestions, in future I'll make videos which will solve your queries. Thank you so much for watching this video.